In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him, all things came to be. Not one thing had its being but through him. All that came to be had life in him, and that life was the light of all people, a light that shines in the dark, a light that darkness could not overpower. A man came sent by God. His name was John. He came as a witness to speak for the light, so that everyone might believe through him. He was not the light, only a witness to speak for the light. The Word was the true light that enlightens all people, and he was coming into the world. He was in the world that had its being through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own domain, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God. To all who believe in the name of him who was born not out of human stock or urge of the flesh or will of man, but of God himself. The Word was made flesh. He lived among us, and we saw his glory, the glory that is his as the only Son of the Father, full of grace and truth. John appears as his witness. He proclaims, "This is the one of whom I said, 'He who comes after me ranks before me, because he existed before me.' Indeed, from his fullness we have all received. Yes, grace in return for grace. Since, though the law was given through Moses, grace and truth have come through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is the only Son who is nearest to the Father's heart who has made him known." The Word became flesh and dwelt amongst us. Earth did not hear the cry, for the earth slept. Men did not hear the cry, for they did not know that a child could be greater than a man. Kings did not hear the cry, for they did not know that a king could be born in a stable. Empires did not hear the cry, for empires did not know that an infant could hold the reins that steers suns and worlds in their courses.